Maybach 1 and 2 were a series of above and underground bunkers built 20 kilometers south of Berlin near Zossen to house the High Command of the Army in Maybach 1 and the Supreme Command of the German Armed Forces in Maybach 2 during the Second World War. Along with the military fortress complex Zossen, Maybach 1 and 2 were instrumental locations from which central planning for field operations of the Wehrmacht took place, and they provided a key connection between Berlin's military and civilian leadership to the front lines of the battle. The complex was named after the Maybach automobile engine. Maybach 1 was built starting in 1937. In December 1939, it was fully operational. The complex consisted of 12 three-story buildings above ground designed to look from the air like local housing and two floors of interlinked bunkers with 2-foot-thick walls below. Later, the site was further camouflaged by the use of netting. Maybach 2 was completed in 1940 and was of the same design with 11 surface buildings. Trial operations began in May 1939 at the Zeppelin News Center, which entered to the hot phase on August 25 when the Army High Command, who had moved from Berlin to Zossen, arrived. By then, all telecommunication connections prepared for the attack on Poland had been switched to the control center. From then on, the camouflage designation Zeppelin, originally intended only for the news bunker, became commonplace for the entire complex of the command post. Regardless of the fact that the headquarters briefly led the army operations in May 1940 on the Western Front, Zeppelin remained for the entire duration of the Second World War the most important, largest, and at the time the most modern telecommunication hub in the Wehrmacht's communication system. Evidence left by the conspirators of the 20 July plot against Hitler was discovered at Maybach 2 in a safe zone at Zossen. Among the documents reportedly uncovered were excerpts from the diary of Wilhelm Canaris, the head of the German military intelligence, conspirational correspondence between Abwehr agents, information on secret negotiations between the Vatican, and data on the resistance activities. Between the 15th and 17th of January 1945, Supreme High Command of the German Army moved back to Maybach 1 from East Prussia. The Army General Staff moved their quarters into Maybach 2. During 1945, the site was heavily bombed and both the British and the Americans, including a raid on the 15th of March that injured Chief of the Army's General Staff Hans Krebs. On the 20th of April, the Soviet 3rd Armored Guard Army threatened the HQ. General Krebs asked Hitler for permission to leave and destroy the important items. By the time Krebs received permission, it was too late to destroy anything. The rapid occupation of Zossen in April 1945 meant that the telecommunications bunker and its systems fell largely undamaged in the hands of the Red Army. While in 1946 the staff bunkers of the High Command of the Army, Maybach 1 and Maybach 2, were blown up after dismantling, the bunkered former Zeppelin News Center was largely spared. After the expansion of its facilities, the building was left to its fate, which resulted in the lower parts being flooded by groundwater. In June 1953, the High Command of the Group of Soviet Armed Forces in Germany was formed. Thus, St. Winsdorf became a restricted area, and as the HQ of the High Command developed into the largest garrison of the Soviet troops in East Germany. Extensive reconstructions of the former German news bunker into a protected command post lasted until the middle of the 1960s. Originally only built to be a gas safe, the bunker should now withstand the effects of nuclear weapons. While maintaining the overall floor plan, several smaller workrooms for the staff departments of the High Command were installed there. Beginning in October 1992, the headquarters was dismantled and the technology was moved back to the Soviet Union. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and support my channel on PayPal. Details in the description box.